Another product review. Sum this one up. Capture cards are getting better and better. HDMI ones are still really pricey. Until now. Have a look at this, shall we? Okay, so here is the box. As you can see, it's quite nicely done with various ascensions, and it's basically got a Transformers. Believe it or not, it's got a link to Transformers. No idea why. HDCP ready. Do high definition content protection on this, which most game consoles now do. PS4, Xbox One, PS Vita TV, which we'll see later. And of course, Chromecast and things like that. The box sides, very generic. Blue, black. It's PCI Express. I bought this for around £46 plus £6 postage. The second attempt I bought from the supplier, I'll link down below anyway, because it just took ages. Well, first time he didn't have it in stock. Didn't tell me until I asked a week later. The second time, was it a week ago? Paid 24-hour dispatch. That was an extra £6 on top, so £52 in total. It doesn't arrive until a week later. Only arrived today. So we're going to look inside. Now, what we got inside is pretty much the basic driver. So you've got a mini CD with the HDMI driver. Just the basic driver, apparently. And then we have the manual. So it's not really a manual, it just tells me a little bit. It tells you what you got. So the product features PCI interface X1, so it's a really tiny PCIe. Only one HDMI input, up to 1.4A, standard 1.4. Supports up to 1080p, up 24 Hz. But supports the smaller resolutions, 480p, 720p, 1080i. Real-time video, so you can use this for streaming and dynamic images for things. Of course, it tells you how to install the driver. I'm just saying using Device Manager to open the driver is not too bad, and you know, install this from list or specific location and go from there. Now, it's interesting it's actually saying about Intel C states. Not sure why, because most times C states shouldn't affect things, but it's actually quite a good guideline. So if you actually have a slow computer, disabling C state can actually improve speed. Basically, Intel C state is a power management technology by Intel, reduces the voltage and frequency of the core in order to reduce power consumption. Fair enough. Might slow it down, so that's what it says. Tells you in the BIOS setups and how it does that. And of course, AMD versions there. And of course, also it tells you how to speed up Windows a little bit by recommends the use of Windows inside the performance is adjusted for best performance. Of course, using this on an i7 or anything, you've got no need to do that, but maybe like a Core 2 Duo or an entry-level Pentium these days. Core 2 Quad, I'll find out, but it should be okay. And that's all you get paperwork-wise. And then you get high low profile bracket, so you can actually fit this in small form factors, basically. And then you have an anti-static bag. Of caution, no static sensitive devices, not to be handled by bypass personnel. You've got the actual card itself, as well as some silica gel. Don't eat the silica gel. Common sense 101. We are going to be testing this out in a second. But here's basically what the card looks like. There's the side of the card where you actually plug the HDMI in. Quite nice and firm tight. And of course, you've got the details of the chip, PCI Express, and you've got various circuits. Probably that's the main chip it processes it with. And it's quite a very small, very lightweight kit. So we're going to be trying this out, and we'll see how we get on with fitting.
So we're going to get this fitted, pretty much. And
how is it going to Steph?
So basically, this is how we get this installed. This in. Oh,
Yeah, well.
So it's finally in after some screwing around, and you can see the HDMI. So pretty much we're going to be getting this back in together. Got a USB fan there, which I use. Good. Apparently, really good fans, really. As you can see right now, is the Vita TV running. So that's really quite responsive. This is at 720p. We'll find out actually. And also we're gonna go position at the fit screen. There we go. So what's is it at the moment? So it's at 720p as you can see. So that's definitely quite good. It's quite responsive, so we're going to see how it goes in games. So I can't play these two because they're not actually on the Vita TV blacklist yet. So we're going to do the Peterpan hack. This should be much better. Maybe the volume is a bit louder than I hoped, as you can probably guess. There we go. So there is some tab, but it's working out some fine. So we're going to see how we get on. As you see, that's capturing. I'm actually playing this as it's capturing. So you see me live playing this, really. It's working swishly. That's responsive. So that's really responsive in terms of what it's doing. And you can see, I can't fault this at all. It worked in OBS like that. Like, no configuration much needed. So we're going to play some Pulse. As also you can see, I'm on 3.18 with the Vita hack of TNV Leave over when 3.18 had the exploit coming out. So, how I'm going to play PSP games on the Vita is amazing at 2. So we're going to play some games, just to test this out. See how fluid and responsive it is in high octane situations. This is so responsive. I haven't done that yet. That's not that doing.
Arc Prime. So that's working really nicely.
That's a guy.
Let's play that for a bit.
What happens when?
3, 2, 1, go.
I know I should mute the music, really. So this is my other sponsor. So this is rather working nicely. And actually the PS TVs is also HDCP protected, so technically this shouldn't happen, but it's letting me do it absolutely fine. And of course it is playing with George Rock. So it's not too bad, I mean, responsive for the most part. There is some stuff. So I can't see too much of this shit, but it's working reasonably good. Whether we're winning the race is a different matter though. Probably not made it. Ooh. Not good, but as you can see, it's on DualShock 3. So. And the Vita TV is looking pretty good.
Second place.
So that's awesomely good in quality.
With that, it was pretty good to show how good quality it was. There was a little bit tearing, but simplicity on setting up. Well, if you use a sign, copy the driver. Wow, the quality was good, responsive. Now, I was playing that on OBS with this. Of course, Minecraft's not the best game I'm good at, but there was no lag time. I was all very minimal lag time, and the quality worked fine. So I could stream any game on Vita TV, and also the fact it was HDCP, it was just streaming it with no problems. It was good. And cost it was quite good. I thought it was also HD, Timeleak HD72A, but it's also Trident 7160, so I'm going to be googling that and see what that means. But I'm going to give this a 6 out of 10. It cheap, reasonably good quality, very responsive. It might be trickier to fit if you're not good at PCs. So a USB version might be a better option for you, but if you know what you're doing, this is ideal and good and cheap to get going with. A budget way to get into good streaming. Anyways, omracer out.
Surfing's around, dodging, all that.